I may someday be able to say that everything I know about being a gentleman, I learned because I first learned to be a lady. Hey, welcome to Out Late But Great. My name is Tim. I'm a guest vlogger this week, and I want to thank Michelle for having me in the collaboration. This is a cool collab, I think, taking older people from the GLBT community and talking about issues. And it is true that queer young people are very active on YouTube, and that's so cool. For older people, there's not a lot. You really have to look for the older people on YouTube. And I think it's a great opportunity, too, for GLBT people to start talking to each other. I have been on YouTube for maybe about a year and a half. I'm somewhat politicized, definitely a lefty, a Democrat. I'm 50, and starting my medical transition from female to male. I've been on testosterone for 8 months, and it's pretty cool. I think there's a lot that gay and lesbian folks could learn about trans folks, and with more understanding from them, I think we can reach out to the straight community and try to engender a little more understanding among them too. Having folks to look up to on YouTube who are older, to see older people living their lives and being out, is just such a great thing, because I think the coming out experience for older people is completely different from coming out when you're younger. Younger folks, their social circles are generally more accepting, but for many of us who are older and still dealing with parents and hometowns and professions and clients and, you know, there are just so many considerations. And also it's a matter of how much disruption are you prepared for. I mean, for me, I think for trans people, it's a little more intense in terms of really turning your world upside down. In terms of being a transgender person, it's not unusual, I think, especially for older people like me, both men and women who are transgender, to not really realize that they're transgender, because again, like I said, we just didn't have a language for that. And for me, I knew that there were men who were transitioning to female, but I didn't know it was possible for women, because I figured it just wasn't going to be allowed. Now, I was so accustomed to being denied things as a female, that I figured this is just another thing that they're going to say, no, you can't be a man, you can be a woman, but you can't be a man. My coming out as trans, well, it's an ongoing thing, you know. Once you come out, you're always coming out, and you have to pick and choose, sometimes, to whom you come out, and where, and when, and why. Like, I just had an experience tonight. I had to go to the ER. I was having breathing problems. I'm fine. But hospital situations for trans people are very difficult. I was lucky that there is a hospital in my area here in Indiana that seems pretty cool. So one time I was there, I told them I was trans. This time I didn't. Yeah, they had to put the things on my chest, and that, you know, that's kind of like game over. I wasn't going to tell them anything. Another thing that I think folks need to know about transgender folks is that we're not all looking for surgery. Some people do, some people don't. Some people haven't had it yet. Part of the whole transgender transition experience is what they call real life experience of living, quote, full time as your chosen gender. And that happens before you have any surgery. So I would like to have surgery on the top, but not on the bottom. That's just me. You know, there's a number of people who feel that way, because I figure as far as downstairs goes, it does, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, you know, because that kind of surgery is kind of touch and go. you know, don't want to lose what I got. So, I like to see more understanding, and I don't know, maybe even teach some people some etiquette. What not to ask when you meet a trans person? I'm pretty forthcoming about things, but it's generally kind of rude to ask people about their genitalia when you first meet them. So, you know, if you meet somebody and they say they're transgender, the polite thing to do would be to maybe congratulate them and ask them if their transition is going well, and leave it at that. If you become friends with someone, they may want to tell you about whether or not they're going to have any kinds of surgeries, but generally speaking, you know, I wouldn't ask questions of trans people that you wouldn't ask of other people. Definitely inappropriate to approach somebody at work and ask them if they've had any surgery. It's like, you know, walk up to a gal and say, "Hey, nice rack. Did you have an operation?" You know, you don't do that kind of thing to people. So that's kind of a pet peeve. But yeah, I'd like to promote more understanding between trans people, gay people, and straight people. So that's me rambling on. And I look forward to seeing the discussions that are going to be coming up on this channel. It's nice to meet you guys. Talk to you later.
There are some who call me Tim.